Driver. And he was one of one of the first ones to board my bus, and I had responsibility for to get safely to and from school.
Right.
And so I still calling my bus, baby, even though he grown up.
Amen.
And
amen.
On Monday night, God said, fit to call one of my bus baby home, the young lady that was killed in SARS. And I had to shed some tears.
Amen.
Because whenever I run into her, you know, it was still like, hey, Miss Harris, I haven't changed God. I talk to him about God then, and I still talk to people about God now, because God is a merciful and a mighty God.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And it's one thing
uh-huh.
I need to say this, because God put it on my heart. He said, be ye also ready, for we know not the time.
That's right.
Not a day, not an hour.
You got it.
But we do know.
He's coming.
That's a trip we all got to make.
That's right.
So we got to be ready.
Amen.
The flesh knows this.
Amen.
But it hurts to see Amen. One go.
Amen.
The heart knows this.
Amen.
The head knows this. The mind knows this, but it hurts to see him go.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
but
ma'am.
We know they just made a trip that we all got to make one.
Amen. Amen. So true. So true.
Yeah, I
take your time.
If there's any minister out here who would love to come up and be with us, we would enjoy having you. To the deacons, to the deaconess, mother, choir, musician, urchin, visitors, saints, and sinners, if there be any. Today is a good day.
It's a good day. It's a good day.
Today is a great day.
It's a great day.
Because as I just explained, he said, be ye also ready, for we know not the day, not the hour.
Amen.
But he's ready. He's willing. He's able to come into your heart and to love you as his own.
Amen.
And to these beautiful urchins out here.
Amen.
Who have a tremendous task on their hands. y'all might not believe this, but I've been struggling with this ever since I've been asked to perform this duty. And I thank God he gave me something. I believe it's gonna work out just as God had planned, because man can't do it. As they say, you can ask me and I can try as hard as I can, but I can't do it. I can't save a soul, but I can tell you what thus says the Lord.
All right, bring it, bring it.
And like Peter and John was going into the temple, and the lame man laying there at the gate, begging alms, and they said, seven gold have I none, but that I have, I do like
you. Right.
Praising God. And that's what we're going to do.
All right.
Be able to walk out of him praising God
for
the blessing and the goodness of his heart.
Amen.
Because he, I don't want to get ahead of myself.
All right. Take your time.
I need to calm down. I need to calm down.
All right. Take your time.
Whoo!
In the night of Jesus.
Take your time.
So good.
Take your time.
God,
take your time.
The Lord is my life.
Yes,
my
son.
And my salvation.
Whom?
Whom shall I fear?
Whom?
The Lord is my strength and my life. Of my life. Whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked eat my enemies.
Say it now.
And my foes come upon me and eat up my flesh. They stumble and fear.
That's right.
And you know, we're going to have a time that it's going to be some trials and some tribulation we have to go through. But if we are to run for Jesus, we got to be prepared. And we got to, and we ask God to help us. I don't care what, who, how the enemy comes, how sickness comes, how trouble comes, how trials come. We are able to stand because he said, I am, Lord, I'm with Yahweh.
Man.
And this is what we got to realize, that we are not alone in this world. Even though we got families and friends all around. Families and friends do what they can, but God can do it all.
That's right.
Because we can't do it down here alone. We can't. There's no way. We can try, but we can't. Hope and hope should encamp against me. My heart shall not fear. No wall should rise against me, and this will I be confident. One thing have I desire of the Lord, and that I will seek after that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, and to hold the beauty of the Lord, and to inquire in his temple. You know, it's a situation. Jesus said, I'm going away. And I'm going away to prepare a place. And where I go, you shall be also. And so if Jesus has gone to prepare a place, I want to see this place. Because I know if Jesus prepared, there has to be something better than down here that man prepared. Because it's not made with brick and mortar. I know it's made with something better. It's something that's going to last forever and ever. Because what does that mean? 1 minute is like 1,000 years. Do you realize that deal how you got to do it, and then you have to go back in and see what, and this church hasn't been that long, did, and you see how many times they have to come in and see about the water, and see about this, and see about that. But when Jesus said he was going away to prepare a place, you ain't got to worry about that place, because he was going to prepare forever.
Amen.
He was going, so if you give him your heart, you give him your soul, and say, if the devil can have anything but my soul, you got everything you need.
Yeah.
You got everything you need. Yeah. It says, for they in thy courts is better than 1,000. I had rather be a doorkeeper in the house of God than to dwell in the tents of the wicked. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace through our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, we want to have peace and we want to be with God, so why not trust in God?
Man.
So we can have that everlasting peace. Not no peace for a few minutes and then, oh man, you did so and so yesterday. God, when he forgives, he throws it into a sea of forgiveness. He brings it up no more. That's the kind of peace and love we want. We want something that's going to last forever and not be thrown back in our face. We want to see that God has for us. We want to work as God can use us. We want to be there for God. And this is why we take on these tasks and say, Lord, use me. Use me, Lord. Use me the way you want to use me. Not the way I want you to use me. Well, I'm going to work for the Lord today, but tomorrow, you know, I got to get out here with my cronies. I got to do with my buddies. I got to do what you can't be the scrawl of the fence.
All right now.
You either going to work for God or you going to work for Satan. You make up your mind. But for me and mine, I'm going to serve the Lord. I have a desire in my heart to see this beautiful mansion he was going to prepare for me. If you go to Romans 5:1-10, it tells us, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom we also have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in the hope of the glory of God. and not only suffer, but be glory in the tribulation also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope. And hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our heart by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. For when we were yet without strength in due time, Christ died for us. For certainly a righteous man will one die. Yet peradventure for a good man, some would even dare to die. And I realize,
amen.
Jesus, being Jesus, the Son, man wasn't that awful at all, that he was willing to save me, a lonely sinner like me, an ungracious sinner. But he said, if the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart.
Harden not your heart.
Come unto me.
Oh, yeah.
And I will give you rest. But first, he had something to do. John 3:16-17 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. But God sent his Son into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Now think about it. Jesus loved us so he come down to die. But God loved us so that he gave his only begotten Son. Jesus gave his life for the sin of this world. But God having to deal with only child. Think about it. Truly think about it. God giving his only begotten child to come down. And Jesus trying, coming down through 42 generations.
Come on, huh? Tell the story.
Get down now and find there's no room in the inn. Now, he done left his home in Grammy and Glory. Had nothing to worry about, but he get here.
Yep.
All right. It's a lonely place.
Fix it up.
And there's not any room in here.
Fix it up. Fix it up.
How do you imagine? But yet and still, there were the sheep, the cows, the goats. Oh, that was a staple.
Pick it up, pick it up.
And he's gonna be lonely, he's gonna be lonely.
Right, right.
So daddy took the mama on out there to the stable and they fixed up his cross and he was born and laid in a manger.
All right.
On the hay.
Tell the story.
And you know, there's people that heard about it and they didn't like what they heard, and so they wanted to find this child. This child ain't got no business in him. We don't need nobody to save these people. We want to run things. And you know the right thing. Some people, if they can't lead, they don't want to follow. But if they don't know how to follow, how is they going to lead? But
just
going back to Jesus, because this is Jesus. And his life went on down the road. God showed him that they had to get him out of there. Oh, wait a minute. Hell, trying to find somebody to kill him, so we can't let him. God done send his Son to save this earth, so he wanted to save his people, so we got to save Jesus. So at the age of 12, he went into this courtroom asking questions of lawyers and doctors and surgeons. He asked the doctor, how do you save doctor, how do you save a man with a sin sick soul? Only through Jesus Christ, but he didn't know that. Lord, stump him. No. God is able.
Yes, he is.
God
is
able. And he's able to do all things. Yeah, he went on and there, this young man out there, put out there in the graveyard, and how he had all these demons and things. He cut himself and got himself and couldn't be brought around other people. Cause anybody know how to hold him? He couldn't hold himself. He couldn't keep the clothes on. But yet he still. Yeah. Jesus went back.
Jesus.
No demon knew who he was. Right. And they said, you know, don't just send us out in nowhere. Put us in the swine. Mm-hmm. God was obedient. Because he didn't wish for no man to die. So he put him in the swine. The swine ran off down the hill and they drowned him in the sea. But the boy was able to walk around and sit around and talk to people. And people looked around and it did the same thing. Yeah, you know, this was the one that cut himself, got himself, couldn't keep on close, couldn't be part of, as they say, the in crowd, as they want to call it these days. He couldn't be a part of that. Man sitting down by the pool of Siloam wanted to be healed 38 years. Every time the water would get stirred, he wanted to get in. Nobody let him put him in. And Jesus came by and said, do you wish to be healed?
Yeah.
He said, yeah, but every time the water gets stirred, somebody stepped in before me. But do you wish to be healed? You know, Jesus, all we got to do is tell him what we want.
And
if you don't tell him what you want, he knows what you want. Right. He wants you to tell him what you want. If you don't ask, you don't get.
Right.
You got to tell Jesus what you want.
Right.
And he said, yes, Lord. He said, pick up that baby and walk.
Amen.
Then he picked up his baby. 38 years, he done laid there. By this pool, waiting on to be stirred, waiting on somebody to put me in, and Jesus come by and say, pick up your
bed.
Who can serve a God like that?
Why?
I tell you, I thank him. And sometimes I have to cry. Because it's a situation where I know can nobody do it but Jesus. When the doctor would walk away from your bed and shake their head and
hallelujah.
Nobody but Jesus.
Nobody but Jesus.
Nobody but Jesus. And they say, I can't give up on God because God hasn't given up on me.
That's right.
I have to keep thinking. And so I'm going to get ready to let y'all go, but I want y'all to know that as they say, he done gave up his home, he done been born, and he out there performing miracles, but yet and still they kind of find a reason to crucify this man.
Tell it.
They want to holler about he blaspheming
against
God. They don't realize that he is God. He came down to do his Father's will.
Amen.
Doing his Father's will.
Amen.
And when he went up into the temple for the Last Supper, he told him, said, brother, can you come with me 1 hour while I go yonder and pray? And you know, sometimes we sit up and we wait in the Sunday and we don't want to stay in church 1 hour. We want you to go ahead and say what you're going to say and let us go home. And he went to pray and he come back and down asleep. He says, oh, you can't watch with me 1 hour while I go and pray.
Well,
you know. And he went off again to pray. And he came back. And they were asleep again. So he said, sleep on. You know. And sometimes you just have to wonder It was sleeping out of life away.
Well,
we waited on Jesus.
Amen.
Because he said, I will be there. Just call me. I will be there.
Amen.
He's able.
He's
willing.
Yeah.
He's, but you have not because you ask not. And then, when the Roman soldiers came, get Jesus, one of the disciples was in an uproar, and he cut off one of the soldiers' ears. Jesus knew what time it was, so he took and put the ear back on, just like it had never came off. Can you imagine that was surgery in itself? To reattach the ear. To reattach the ear. Because it's, wait a minute, what was the disciple? Wait a minute. You know, you're doing these things. And you are supposed to be my disciple. This has been set aside for me. Me for you. And me for the world is to go and to save the world. And all for me to go and save the world, I must go to the cross.
Yeah,
So I have to do this. I have to put this back. And we got to keep everything in order. And so when we do things, we must learn to do them in decent and in order. Because this is the way it's supposed to go. So they took him on back and they judged him in three courthouses, and he never said a mumbling word.
Tell the story.
And then they took him down by Pilate, and Pilate talked. Why he told him, though, hey, I'm going to do with this man.
Yeah.
I bring him some water, let me wash my hands. Woo! Taking him back up there, and they decided, well, we got to crucify somebody. Well, he had over rabbits up there, so. Who you want to release? Jesus or Barabbas? Everybody wants Barabbas. Well, you know he's a sinner. You know what he done been for the world. We got to let somebody go, and we can't let this Jesus go. So we got to let Barabbas go. That's the only choice he gave us. It was between Jesus and Barabbas, and so Barabbas go free. But see, Barabbas is one thing they didn't realize. Barabbas couldn't save him. Had they told to let Jesus go free, we'd have still been in sin. So that was why God enabled them to let the rabbits go. A lot of people run today, they hear about the rabbits and don't know why the rabbits got chosen to be let go. Because that they had a chosen Jesus to let go and the rabbits to be crucified. Then we'd have been in the same state today if we was back then. But Jesus knew the plan. And, you know, I don't care whether you're building a house or some people say baking a cake. You got to have a plan.
Amen.
Because if you go in the kitchen to bake a cake and have no eggs, I have no oil, I have no flour, you don't really end in a bag of cake, do you?
Mm-hmm.
I ain't serious. You don't think about it.
Come on now.
And so they were determined they had to let somebody go. So they wanted to let Barabbas go. And that was in God's plan.
All right.
And so.
Tell the story.
They marched him all the halls.
Tell the story.
They couldn't find no fault in him, but since the people said let Barabbas go, they let Barabbas go. And on Friday morning, they marched him up the hill.
Tell it.
They put that old rugged cross on his shoulder.
Tell the story.
And according to everything, it was a heavy cross. And we all got our crosses to bear. And there was a poor man came along and said, "My Jesus, bear this cross alone. And all the world go free."
Tell it.
But you know, in a Christian, I can hear somebody say,
No.
There's a cross for everyone.
Yes, it is.
And there's a cross for me. They went there, and they nailed his hands,
Tell the story.
And they remember his feet. But one thing they forgot, he said, if I be lifted up, I'll grow. Not you grow, but if I be lifted up, I'll grow. All men unto me.
Yes, sir.
And when they lifted that cross, they lifted up Jesus. They lifted him up to eternity. They didn't realize. And he told them, no man taketh my life. But my life I will freely give.
That's right.
That this world might have. It didn't say you have. But it might have. Because you've got to make up in your mind.
Come on now.
If you want to trust God,
yeah.
He's not going to make it. He's standing there. He's not. He's waiting on you.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
But they lifted him up. Mm.
Yeah.
Between two sinners, one hanging on either side.
Yeah.
One on the one side said, hey, you been Jesus. Why don't you save yourself and save us?
Yeah.
Well,
I'm saying, wait a minute. When you get in your father's house, please remember me.
Yeah.
And that's what I keep asking him every day. Lord,
remember me. Remember me.
I need you, Lord, to remember me.
Yes.
A prolonged sinner. And I can remember. One Monday evening.
Come on.
Down in the little church.
Just a.
Yeah.
Well. And they've been singing. He's been shouting.
Well.
And his old mother was sitting all in the car.
Tell a story.
And she said, if I don't wake up in the morning. To tell the world that I will stand for Jesus.
Yeah.
And I want to stand on God's word.
My.
Because Jesus came through by God's word. But it came from, and if you notice and if you read the Bible, it tells you about it all back in the Old Testament. You don't have to wait until you get to the New Testament. The New Testament tells you about his birth and his life and what he did and his death and his burial and his resurrection and what he was going away to do. But the Old Testament tells you about the coming. He's coming and what he's going to do. Because at the time, and you got to have faith. You got to have as much faith as Moses had when he was standing by this burning bush that's not being consumed. You got to have as much faith as Noah did when he said, "Build my ark."
Yeah.
You got to have as much faith as Daniel did when they put him in the lion's den. Or maybe before he put him in the lion's den, because they told him if he keep praying, they was going to put him in there. But then he said, "Let them put me in there."
Well,
going back to the cross, y'all. I told y'all, I feel good. Mm-hmm. And I thank God. I thank God. And I thank God.
Amen.
But then, he hung there from the 6th to the 9th hour.
Tell a story.
And then he said, "It's finished."
Boy.
He hung his hands in the locks of his shoulders and said, "It's finished."
Finished.
It's over.
Yeah.
It's over. And they took him down.
Tell a story. Tell it.
Yeah. All night, Friday night.
Yeah.
All day Saturday.
Yeah.
All night, Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
But early.
Early.
Woo! Early Sunday morning.
Early.
He got up.
Got up.
He got up.
Yeah.
When he got up, he said, "All power.
All power.
All power is in my hand."
Yeah, man.
All power.
All power.
In earth. Yeah. On earth is in my hand.
That's right.
Not black power, but all power. Not white power, but all power. And you know, I can remember like it was yesterday. These old ladies used to sing, "If it wasn't for Jesus, what would I do?"
All right, all right.
"If it wasn't for the Lord, what would I do?" And you know, at my new hope, I had already experienced some stuff.
All right.
But at my new hope, to kind of feel what they were talking about, but I didn't always understand, and maybe I don't now. As they say, I'm gonna get ready to turn 70, y'all, and I know to some of y'all in here they don't, but for some of y'all I'm older than dirt. But at the same time, I want to tell you something, and God will be my witness. There's more. The longer you live, you need to learn something. And the day that you think you can learn something new is the day you ask God to take you home. Because we need to learn something new every day.
Right.
Every day. Because God is ready, he's able, and he's willing. And he's coming back. And he's coming back after a church without a spot on it. He's coming back.
Oh, yeah.
After them.
Yeah.
He's coming back.
Coming back.
For the righteous.
Amen.
He's coming back.
Uh-huh.
For the one who's not ashamed. He's coming back.
Yeah.
For the one who willing to stand on his word.
Yeah.
He's coming back.
Yeah.
To get the one who's ready.
Amen.
So he said, "Be ye also ready."
Uh-huh.
But we know not the day, not the hour. This concludes my message.
Amen.
And I pray that y'all got some knowledge.
Amen.
The doors of the church is open. Y'all might come by letter, by Christian and Spirit, by candidate for baptism. And I would pastor say, Lord bless you. You can come with that A, B, C. A, I accept knowledge that I am a sinner. B, I believe Jesus died for my sin. And C, I confess it right now. We're here. The doors of the church is open. You may come. And maybe you belong to another church. And God has laid it on your heart to come here in Macedonia.